What's up, hustlers? It's your boy JTS who's back in with another video. And I enjoyed the brainstorming session we had so much the other day that I decided to do another one. So put your thinking caps on. Let's get into it. Let's brainstorm again and figure out what we can do as young entrepreneurs to create businesses that can help ourselves, help our families, help others.
I never feel like poor me. I'd rather feel like the old me. I was born with wheels and I rolled deep. I could make the devil get cold feet. Don't like the clover, less it's four leaf. Get a pussy wetter than a coral reef. On my face, I tatted me a fleur de lis. Should I get it covered with a coca leaf?
All right, hustlers, so I want to start off this brainstorming session like this. I go to Walmart to grab little things that I need around the house, just like a lot of other people. And in a lot of Walmarts, I notice they have a nail shop. And inside of that nail shop, you know, I notice that the people who perform the services and own the business and are working there look different from the consumers of that business. Now, you know, this is not to be misconstrued as a race thing or anything like that. The whole idea of this brainstorming session is I want people to just think about doing different things. So I want people to think about you're not limited to what business you can do or the businesses that you can't do. So I want you guys to comment below just to get the ball rolling on what industries do you think that you're a heavy consumer of, but you don't see a lot of people owning those businesses. Now, there are nail salons that are ran by people that look just like the consumers. I am aware of that, but I'm just talking about, I think what I find most interesting about businesses like this is why don't other people venture out into those businesses? So, not just saying a nail shop, but I don't know what this business is called, but I've been to a lot of different malls. And it's like ladies get their eyebrows flossed or whatever it's called. It's like somebody just has a string and they're just going to town on somebody's eyebrows. And it's always girls in that little center section of the mall. Same thing, they do massages like that in the center of the mall. Chinese food restaurants. I see more consumers at Chinese food restaurants that don't look Chinese, but the business owners are Chinese. And this is not a knock to them. I'm going to keep on reiterating that. This is not a knock to them. They perform a necessary service. They're doing great business. They're thriving. And I love all entrepreneurs. This brainstorming session is just to have you ask yourself the question, I wonder why. I wonder why so many people are consumers in this industry, but when we look at the owners, there are not a lot of variations when it comes to the owners. And maybe there are some barriers to entry in these businesses that I am not aware of. I think exposure is everything. Exposure, awareness. Let's put this out in the open. I'm going to talk back and forth with my family, you guys, and we just going to see, you know, what businesses are out there that you think we should pursue as entrepreneurs. We're using our dollars. And when I say ours, I'm talking about everybody in the Hustle family. We using our dollars at all these different businesses. But when we look at them, they're dominated by people that's not like us. And why can't we get our piece of the pie? Why can't we start our own social media company and be the next Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, or whatever? Why can't we have our own big tech company that's even bigger than Facebook and all of those other social media companies? And now I'm sure if I did a ton of research, I probably can find at least one person of every ethnicity in all of these different businesses. You guys know what I'm saying. You guys see that some businesses are monopolized by certain people, but we're the consumers of them. Like, why can't we come out with our own shoe brand that's bigger than Adidas, bigger than Nike's? Come out with clothing lines that are bigger than Moncler, bigger than Gucci, bigger than Prada, Armani, or what have you. Why do you think there isn't more entrepreneurs? Narrow down that question even more. Why do you think that so many people are willing to go support all of these industries, but they're not willing to invest in that industry and set themselves up, set their families up, and allow people to support them? This is not just to you guys. This is some soul searching that I need to do as well. Like, I can look in the mirror and ask myself, why don't you have a Chinese restaurant? You know, it might sound funny to somebody out there, but I eat Chinese food. You know, I don't eat it super frequently, but, you know, I don't have anything against it. And even if we want to go one more step beyond that, let me know your guys' thoughts on why aren't we trying to franchise our businesses? We can open up a barbershop. Why can't we franchise out these barbershops to be nationwide? I can open up a courier service if I just point the finger at me. I can open up a courier service, but why don't I make my courier service nationwide? You know, it just takes some soul searching from all of us, and I hope that this video is just makes you think. Just makes you wonder if you want to be an entrepreneur or if you are a current entrepreneur. Can we do more? Why don't we do more? I have a lot of different thoughts on it, and I look forward to hearing you guys' input on it. I think a big part of it is that there's status quos, if you understand what I mean. So it's kind of accepted that these people do this, these people do that, and it's not a lot of crossing the line. Granted, some people might say that they're stretching themselves too thin. Some people might feel like they're making great money in the industry that they're in. All of that is a reality. I'm guilty of it too. I'm working on that myself. And I appreciate all of you guys for supporting the channel and all the feedback you left on the previous brainstorm video. And I also want to thank you in advance for the feedback you're going to leave on this brainstorm video. Whether it be good or bad, it's still all love. To all my hustlers, stay hustling. JT Hustles, I'm gone.
Sweet dreams, our nightmares. It's a cold world. I got an ice grill. No one man should have all that power. If you can't afford to pay the light bill, I got a force field over my heartbeat. The windowsill with no door.